In Delhi now, you're never far from heartbreak. Almost everyone in this city has been visited by grief. At the Seema Puri crematorium, the loss weighs heavily in the smoldering air. And the dead are piling up.
There are bodies literally everywhere you turn here. I've honestly never seen anything quite like it. And the organizers say that pre-COVID, they might cremate 7 or 8 people a day. Today alone, they've already cremated 55 bodies, and it's not even lunchtime.
Just months ago, India's leadership boasted that the country had effectively defeated COVID. Now it has set global records for new cases as a terrifying second wave ravages the country. Jitender Singh Shunti says he and his men don't even stop to take breaks. And still, they can barely cope with the flow. A volunteer approaches. They've run out of tables for the bodies, he says, then adds that his mother died from COVID the night before.
You must be tired.
Very. But this time is not for the rest.
Do you believe the government figures, the death tolls, the COVID figures that they're giving, or do you think the real figures are much higher?
The numbers that you're seeing on television are the numbers of people who are dying in hospitals, he says. They're not factoring in the people who died at home in isolation. If those numbers are added, the actual number will go up by 3 times. To keep up with those mounting numbers, the crematorium has been forced to expand, creating an overflow area in a neighboring car park. Shyam Sharma is saying goodbye to his 45-year-old younger brother.
Last night, I was thinking that his health is improving, but suddenly the phone of doctor came on my mobile phone that your brother has expired.
Do you think his death could have been prevented?
Yes, I think he can save. We can save him with a better health hospital.
India's healthcare system is at a breaking point. Unable to cope with the scale of the crisis, its people left to fend for themselves. This crowd has been waiting for 6 hours for the chance to get some oxygen. They can't rely on the state.
Who do you need oxygen for?
My mother.
Your mother? How old is she?
47.
And is her oxygen very low?
She's in very critical condition.
58%. 58%. And we are trying since morning. We are not getting the oxygen anywhere.
How many places have you been to?
19.
19?
Since morning, since 6 a.m.
Have you tried taking her to the hospital?
There are no beds.
There are no beds.
Before 4 days, we have tried so much, but we didn't get any beds.
Priya Srivastava was lucky enough to find her mother a place in a hospital, only to find out there was no oxygen.
Around 10 deaths I have seen in front of my eyes. What should I do? And I'm so scared what's going to happen with my mom.
Are you angry?
I'm so angry because of this organization. Our government is so careless. They even don't care about what public is suffering. They don't know what from which thing we are suffering. There are so many people who are standing over there and fighting for this thing.
Her mother is now in critical condition. Like many here, she feels completely overwhelmed. For those who can't source their own oxygen, this is the only option. A drive-in oxygen center by the side of the road. A woman arrives unconscious in a rickshaw. Several hospitals have already turned her away. They simply didn't have the beds. Now she is relying on the kindness of strangers. Her sons work desperately to try to revive her.
This isn't a hospital or even a clinic. It's a Sikh temple. But for these people who've already been turned away from so many hospitals, this is their last chance at survival.
The leader of the Sikh charity that runs this facility says it gets no support at all from the government. He says he already had COVID twice. But he and his volunteers continue to work 24 hours a day.
We want to save their lives. This is our heart's voice.
It must hurt your heart to see the way your people are suffering.
Yes, madam. Many times we cry also. What is going on?
It is impossible to escape the tragedy of this vicious second wave. Coronavirus is ravaging the old, but it has not spared India's young. The Prime Minister has announced that everyone over the age of 18 can get the vaccine. But with less than 2% of the country inoculated, that offers only a distant hope. So India's capital continues to burn, suffocated by the rampant spread of this deadly virus. A city and a country brought to its knees, praying for respite.